Morning, guys. This is my last one for this period. Anyway, we're obviously all going into lockdown from Thursday, so I'm going to repost all the ones that I've done previously, so you can have another go at them if you want, and hopefully you will do, and enjoy them, and try and keep fit through this period. Just try and keep distracting yourself, doing different things. That's what I've tried to do for these last 14 days. To be fair, they've flown by. So let's hope they do for you. We've got 4 weeks of it still to come, haven't we? So make sure you've got some water. And if you want to, we've got some weights as well. I've got some weights, just 3 kilogram ones, that I'm going to use. I've got some Russian twists, and we are doing sit up and roll ups where we're going to use some weights as well. So but you don't have to use weights if you don't want to. We're doing a circuit with a little bit of active rest in the middle of it, so I'm sure you'll enjoy it. If you've done any of my classes before, we've done these before, so just enjoy it, and we will crack on. I'll crack on with a warm up, and then we'll go straight on. So just start with your ankle, warming it up one way, and then the other, and changing. Push your heel into the floor, straightening the back leg, bending the front leg, tipping your back, chest open, then bend the back leg, pointing the straightening the front leg, and then bring the toes up on that front leg. Take a step forward, bending the front leg, pushing the heel into the floor of the back leg, straighten that front leg, and point the toes along the floor to start with, pushing your bottom out, tip your toes up, and then you should feel it all the way up your hamstrings. I can certainly feel it today. And let's just start with a couple of little squats. If you keep it in time with the music, just, you're not all the way down yet, lift that down and then bring your knee up. We've got some squat high knees coming up in the circuit. We've also got some frog jumps, so we'll just practice those. Legs nice and wide, knees going out to the side. We're keeping them strong, so you're working your glutes. If you want to just stick with frog jumps, that's fine. We're going to do some traveling frog jumps, so if you're happy with that. If it's too much, you can just come down and then come up to your heels. Keep your arms on the top. Not so much. We've got some yoga moves in the active rest parts. The first one is going to be Warrior One. So your hips are in line, feet are in line. Take a step back with your right foot, turn it out. We're going to bring the arms up, bend that front knee. So we're actually dropping down through the hips. So I won't show this when we're going straight into it. So that's Warrior One. Then you've got Warrior Two, where you turn your foot slightly further out and you're gazing across that front finger. And then we've got Warrior Three, which is up on one foot. Forward and backwards. You can be here, that's fine, or you can be here. Try and keep those hips as long as you can. Bring the right hip down. Good. Those are your first three active rests. We've got some others, which I'll save for later, which do in a minute. So bring your hips open. And then take it the opposite way. Bringing the elbow around. And get those feet involved with a little jog. And then when we go to sprinting, we're going to bring those knees up, because we are doing sprints. in the first. That's going to be first exercise. So bring those heels up to your butt. If you don't want to do sprinting, this is what an alternative you could do. The arms circles. And again, a little jump. Well done, okay. Let's get cracking. Okay, 5 seconds to go. We're going to start with sprinting. So,
2, 1, go.
Again, this time we're tipping forward, bring the arms up, keeping the hips level,
3, 2,
bring in your 1, arms,
go.
And legs down. If you need to hold on to something, you can. The lower you are, the better it is, but you can be here, and it's absolutely fine. You're trying to get that straight line, trying to bring that hip. Wherever you think your hip is, bring it further down, because it's all likely to be parallel.
3, 2,
if it is, brilliant.
1.
That was our right leg. So, we're on the floor. We've got sit up and roll, sit ups or roll ups.
3,
I'm using 2, some weights.
1.
So I'm going to roll down and then roll back up. You can use the weights above your head and roll them forward so you can reach for your toes. Out behind you, reach your toes. So take it nice and slow, rolling down, rolling back up. push that lower back into the floor as you bring it down.
One.
And then out.
Rest.
Well done. We are back to warrior one. This time on our left leg. So feet parallel. Take a step back with the left leg, arms come up, a little squat down. So you can make that stance nice and wide, you can push back into the heel, try to get that front leg parallel, and we're dropping down in between the hips, we're not leaning forward, we're actively reaching up and back if you can. 10 seconds left. Keep breathing. Keep going.
3, 2, 1.
Lovely.
Rest.
Good, we're back on the floor. We're doing Russian twists. So we're going from one side. You can use two weights if you want.
3, 2, 1.
I've got 6 here. So we're lifting the legs up. Take the whole body with you when you're doing these Russian twists. Working your obliques and you're working your tummy as well. Keeping the legs off the floor. But if you need to, bring them back down. Keep going. Keep your chest up, keep leaning back slightly. 4 seconds left.
3, 2, 1. Oh. Rest.
Well done. Okay, back up, warrior two. Left leg this time. So back at an angle.
3, 2.
Bending that front leg. One. You should still be able to see the toes. This time the right hand comes forward. You're looking over that middle finger, your shoulders are up, back and down, and you're gazing across that front leg, front arm. Keep going, keep breathing. Well done, 5 seconds left.
3, 2,
back in your glutes.
1,
rest. Lovely. Downhill hold. So basically this is just a squat. You can use your weights with this if you like.
3, 2.
So
one.
You're just holding. So it's, imagine you were a ski jumper and you're just holding that squat, bouncing gently. So bottoms down, chest up. Keep breathing. Keep that little bounce going. Make sure you can still see your toes, make sure your weight's
3, 2,
weighted into your 1, heels.
Rest.
Good. Warrior three. This time the left leg's tipping back. 3, so you can bring your arms 2, up.
1,
palms facing. 2, lean forward. You will find that one leg will be more balanced than the other, or stronger. It's not wrong if you wobble. In fact, it helps. Going. Keep reaching forward, pushing back with the leg. Ah, I lost it. Side sweep lunges. So we're going arms up, we're sweeping the leg down to a bent leg, and then sweeping down through the other side. So sweeping across, sweeping down. And sweep into the side and go, room! Ah, you can add that jump. So if you start from here, sweep it down. Ah, knew I was going to do that. Yeah. Stretching down to that one. Making a cross down to the other one.
3, 2, 1. Rest.
Sorry, that was a bit of a mess there. If you want to, you can just keep it nice and slow. Down to one side. Then feet back in, down to the other side. Stretching out, so make sure you've got more room than me. Okay, we're gonna do all those again. But this time, we've got some different active rests. Your first one in this next section is a borrower squat combo. So we're gonna be down into a borrower squat with our hands forward, palms clenched together. We're gonna go out to the side, back, side, and back outside all the way across. So here we go, we're going to start again. We're going to start with sprints. So we're back on sprints. They're a little bit longer, these rounds. We've got 40 seconds. Keep going. Keep bringing those knees up. It is supposed to be a sprint. We've got 20 seconds. We're halfway there now. Keep going. And then we've got that squat combo. Warrior squat combo. 5, 4.
Three, two, one.
So that squat combo, down, out to side, behind, out to side, behind, behind, out to side. Keep going. We've got 40 seconds. Keep it low. Keep going. You're working your glutes. Keep the weight into your heels as you're stretching across. Keep going. Doesn't really matter what order you're doing in them. We're doing them in. Keep going. Staying low. Well done. So we're going to repeat that on the next, on the fourth one.
Three,
travel in.
Two,
frog jumps, one. Or just frog jumps. I'm just going to stick to frog jumps. But make sure you use your knees, your hips, your ankles as a shock absorber. So when you're landing, everything comes down. Really touch the floor if you can. Each one. We're over halfway there now. Keep going. Keep going. When I said halfway, I actually went halfway through the frog jumps. Down.
Three, two, one.
Get away, bitch. Oh, grab water when you need it. We have got some lateral crab walks and then a press up.
Three, two, one.
Hands together, feet together, then a press up. Hands together, feet apart, hands together, feet together, hands apart. So crab walk, and then down for a press, across, and then down for a press. Bring the hands together, feet come apart, hands come together, feet come apart, down for that press. If you want to alternate it, you can do a narrow arm press up, or a wide arm press up with your feet together.
One.
Well done. Oh, that's tough that one. We're on squat high knees.
Three, two, one.
So two, three. Up. High. Keep your hands up if you like. Plank, leg raises for the next active rest.
Three, two, one, rest.
So we're down for a plank. Just stay in the plank if you want to.
Three, two, one.
Hold. There's an alternative. Lift alternate legs. Keep your hips down. So you're really getting into those glutes when you're lifting those legs. Keep going. This means you're just about halfway. Keep your hips facing down towards the floor. If you need to at any point, you can drop down to your knees, but try and keep those hips down if you can. Pointing your toes.
Two.
Stay in there.
One.
Rest. Well done. Drop back into Charles for a second if you need a stretch out. We're rolling over onto our sit-ups.
Two.
Or our roll-ups and roll-downs. So rolling down and then rolling back up. If you want to have your arms at your chest this time and then reach forward. were you to call me up? Keep going. Reaching forward and down and across. Reaching forward. Reaching over. Start to call me up.
Three, two,
reach forward. Rest. Well done. So that's your sit up. You're back to, we're back to lateral crab walks with a press up.
Three, two,
so
one.
Hands and wide feet together. Feet wide, hands together. Hands wide, feet together. Down for the press. Hands together, feet wide. Hands wide, feet together. Down for that press. Hands together, feet wide. Hands apart, feet together. Hands together, feet together. Down. You can just stick with crab walk if you like. You can drop the press ups, or you can just stick with press ups. Drop down to your knees. But try and keep that body long. Roll back, stretch your arms. If you need to, bring your head down towards the floor. Breathing into your tummy.
Three, two,
up for down.
One.
Rush and twist. We're on. What are we on? No, we're not. Yes, we are. Rush and twist. What are we doing? It's been a long week. Keep going. And I don't need your eyes no more. Cause the truth is without you, I am stronger. And I know if I could I change the color. Then it's gone. I'm over you. Come on, man. We're up on our feet for our next one. With those pulse borrower squat combos.
Three, two.
Whoa.
Well done.
Rest. So we're down into that squat. And legs are going out to the side and then back.
Three, two, one.
Go.
Go.
Side, back. Stay low. Do one leg and then do the other. If you can stay low, that's the ideal. Leg out to side, behind, side, side. Keep your legs strong.
Three, two,
one last one.
One.
Next one, just because we need to do more squatting, we're down into that downhill hold. Remember, keep those legs strong, weight into the heels. So it's as if you're downhill skiing, just taking those little jumps out. Keep the weight to the heels. Let me see you bounce. Arms up if you want to. Bring them down.
Three, two, one.
Rest. Well done. We're down onto the floor to do those plank leg raises. So remember, you can do them from your knees as well.
Three.
So if you're down on your knees, you're here, you want to do a leg lift from there, absolutely fine. Or if you just want to stick in the plank there, pausing here, as long as you're keeping the hips down, the tummy strong, tighten the glutes, tighten the thighs. If you want to come up onto your toes, push back into your heels, still keeping everything tight, pulling towards the centre line. Then lift alternative legs. You've got 8 seconds left. Remember, drop down to your knees at any point. Come back in when you're ready.
Two, one.
Well done.
Rest.
Last one, side sweep lunges. So we're gonna slow these down while I am. So the arms are up.
Two, one.
Reaching off to one side. Then up, then down. You can add a little jump if you've got room, but be careful. right into the inner thigh, really strengthens it. But be careful you don't get any groin strains. Take it slower if you need to. I feel a little twinge there, that's why I'm just slowing it down a bit.
3, 2, 1, rest.
Well done, 45 seconds rest. Grab water for the last round. We've only got 8 minutes to go. But this next one tends to be a little bit hectic. So we're gonna try, basically we do two together, following on for each other. So we're gonna do a sprint and then traveling frog jumps. And then we're gonna do two of the borrower, the active rests. So the two warriors come after that. So I'll tell you, we've got 30 seconds running, and then 30 seconds frog jumps. And then we're gonna do warrior one on the right, and then we're gonna adjust the feet and go into warrior two on the right. Okay? So we've still got 10 seconds running. Make sure you're light on your toes, make sure you're up on your toes.
3, 2,
no rest.
One,
straight into frog jumps. Keep going.
3, 2, 1.
Got 10 seconds. Adjust. We've got warrior one. So take your right leg back. Feet facing forward. Bend that front knee. Arm comes up. Push back into that heel, breathing. The toes can be turned out slightly if it's more comfortable. We add a little back bend if that's comfortable. Hips are still facing forward.
3, 2, 1.
Then adjust. Bring that left hand down in front, right hand goes out behind, and reaching forward, gazing over that middle finger. The back foot is turned out to about 45 degrees. Bring your arms up, back and down, chest open. Those front thighs, make sure they don't track in, keep them strong. Got 15 seconds. Okay, we're gonna swap a couple around. So we're gonna go squat high knees. And then.
3, 2.
So we squat high knees first, and then we're downhill hold. Squat high knee. Squat high knee. Oh, that jump. So we're downhill hold after this if you want. To grab your weights, you can nab.
Nab. 3, 2.
Oh, here we go. One. Downhill hold.
Go.
And then the arms coming up. Well done.
2, 1.
15 seconds.
Rest.
We've got next ones. We'll do warrior one and two on the left hand side this time. So left leg back this time.
3, 2,
feet facing forward.
1.
Arms up. Bend that front knee. You'll see the hips facing forward. Dropping down. Make sure that knee doesn't track in or out. Keep breathing. So the next one, we're going to adjust and drop that right hand forward, opening the back foot to about 45 degrees. So the back foot goes out, and the front knee stays strong, but the hips are facing towards my door. Keep breathing. Nice deep breath. Arms are up, back and down. Ring my bell. Keep strong. Make sure that knee doesn't track in. Keep it strong. Wait until the heel.
Rest.
Well done. We've got side sweep lunges and then roll ups and roll downs. So we're going to take the arms up, sweep them towards that bent leg. Remember, I got a little twinge last time, so I'm going to take it slowly. I think it's just your age, or my age anyway. Certainly, you get a few twinges. That's 14 days worth of exercises almost every day. So, and I've been doing some yoga for the other days. Been helping my mum with some yoga moves for her. Keep swinging down. We've got 4 seconds left. And then we're down on the floor to do those roll up and roll downs. So we're rolling down and then rolling up. Rolling down. Rolling up. Rolling down. Rolling up. Rolling down. And then rolling up. Try and get your head all the way down. Try and touch your toes on each one. Take it nice and slowly.
3, 2, 1, rest.
Well done. We've got warrior three on the right and then warrior three on the left. So the arms are going to come up and then we're going to lean forward, balancing on the left leg first. Reaching forward. Remember, you can use something to help you balance. Try and bring the right hip down, push your heels back. If you need to bend your support leg, that's absolutely fine. Stretching forward, palms facing.
3, 2,
and then back up,
1,
and then swap sides. Left leg comes up. Toes pointing down towards the ground. Keep that hip down. Arms facing each other, looking down towards the floor. Maybe just a head. Maybe about 30 degrees. Keep going. 4 seconds left.
3, 2, 1. Rest.
Well done. God, I'm dripping. Sometimes I get a good feeling. Okay, we have got
3, 2
lateral crab walks. Then coming across. If you want to work those press ups, you can mix an arm together, out, and hands and feet. Sometimes. The only reason I'm doing more crab walks is because I'm going to squeeze.
3, 2, 1.
We're going to stay in plank and then leg raises.
As for me and my house, I'm not bothered about what men may say. When the tired
years, well done, hips down.
And there's never been a casket rolled through people's temples. When 24 times in this year, and the year's not out, they've brought the dead in the doors, and they've run
keep
out
going.
When they've dropped dead in their feet, they've been resurrected. I'm not talking about what you have to say.
Remember, you can drop to your knees, if you need to.
Work out completed.
What's going on? We didn't get to do our Russian twists. Damn it. I thought we had enough. I was thinking we didn't have enough rounds to go then. Well done. Okay, I'm just going to do a quick cool down and then I'll let you go. So I hope you're all well. Like I say, I'm going to repost everything so you can have another go at these ones. I'll repost my other ones as well that I've done before. And breathing into it, feel that stretch on. We had this last time, didn't we? And bring your arms back down. Bring that foot in slightly, straighten that front leg, bend the back leg, push the bottom out. So you think about pushing your bottom out, straightening that front leg. And bring the toes up on that front foot.
Time is in the jam, she'll be by your side, but it doesn't really.
loose my courage. Try and keep your back straight if you can. So if you need to, soften your knees so your hamstrings aren't screaming too much. And just let your hands hang nice and loose. You've got to grab hold of some weights here. It's a really good way to get some space between your shoulders and your shoulder blades. Only you need the light weight, really. So just let your arms hang loosely. Spin in one direction and then just change the direction. And again, soften your knees if you need to. Those hamstrings might start singing. The natural activity. Drop those weights and then roll yourself back up nice and slowly. And then his body can handle, but all he can say is little squats. One more. And then you're done. Well done. Alright, guys, see you later. So have a safe one and have a go at all the rest of them as well. Okay, take care, bye.